Hey everyone, Sleepy here, and welcome to a new pickup video. Got a really special pickup I'm going to share with you guys today, but we're going to save that one for the end. First, we're going to start off with something I got at the Goodwill. Now, it's not video game related, but it's still an awesome item. And it is a DVD box set, and it is for the complete 1994 Iron Man series, which is awesome. This collection is in immaculate condition, as you can see. Slipcover. Has no dings or anything in it. Neither does the case. The discs are like brand new. And this only cost me $2, which is awesome. I haven't seen this show in years, but I really did enjoy it. So I'm definitely going to be popping this in here soon and watching because I really did like it. And hey, you know, for $2, you can't beat that for a whole complete series. And I love getting DVDs at the Goodwill. Get some Blu-rays there every now and again. But I do pick up quite a bit of DVDs because they're really cheap, and it's a great way to build up your collection, so be sure to check out your Goodwills and other thrift stores. You guys can really build up your movie collection for cheap, so happy with that. Now we'll move on to stuff from the game stores. Grabbed an original Game Boy title, and that was a copy of Tarzan, Lord of the Jungle. And the condition is really good, and I popped this in recently. Played it for a little bit, and I'm really having fun with it. I would definitely recommend picking up a copy if you like Game Boy. Really cool little adventure game. Definitely happy to have that, and for a dollar, you know, I could not say no, so glad with that. Now I'll share with you guys some of my original Xbox titles I picked up. It seems like all the game stores in my area lately have just been constantly getting in more and more original Xbox titles, which is awesome, because last year there was, for a while, I just couldn't find any that I didn't have. You know, they just kept having the same ones and were getting smaller and smaller. And now it seems like this year, they're really building up in the original Xbox game. And I guess everyone just in my area wants to sell them off, so, which is awesome. You know, I'm picking up more titles I need. So first up, I grabbed a copy of Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon 2, which I loved the Ghost Recon games. Haven't played this one in a while, so I'm definitely going to have to pop it in, check out the story. Of course, you can't play multiplayer anymore since the servers are shut down, but, you know, you can still at least play the story. It's complete, and I got that for a dollar. Next up, grabbed a copy of SX3, snowboarding game, pretty cool series. Complete. That one was $5. Also got a copy of SX on Tour. That's cool. I just need one more game in the series, and I'll have all of them for the Xbox. That one was also complete. Paid $5 for that one. I grabbed another NASCAR title. It was NASCAR 2006 Total Team Control. I only need one more NASCAR game. It's NASCAR Thunder 2004, and I'll have all the NASCAR games for the Xbox. It's complete. Paid $5 for that. This next title is pretty cool, and that was a copy of Mike Tyson Heavyweight Boxing, which this is actually kind of an uncommon Xbox title. I've had a very hard time locating one, but the game store recently got one in, so very happy with that. Looks like a fun game. I haven't checked it out yet, but I'm definitely going to be popping it in here soon. I like boxing games, so I want to check it out. It's in excellent condition. It's also complete, and that one only cost me $5, which is awesome, so happy with that. Got another Shrek title, and that was Shrek Super Slam. Complete. Paid $5 for that. Picked up one Xbox 360 game, and that was a copy of The First Templar, which this is actually a pretty fun game. Doesn't have the best graphics, and sometimes the fighting mechanics look weird, but I've had a lot of fun with the game. Has some great RPG elements. It has three playable characters, and you can switch between them. You can also do co-op, and there's some humor and stuff in the game. Definitely, it's worth playing through. It's a budget title. I only paid $5 before, and it's not bad. About halfway through the game, the disc is currently in my 360, and I'm definitely want to complete this one. I would recommend it if you like little quirky games. You know, you can get it for under $10. I would say pick it up, but I'm happy with that one. Next up, we have a copy of Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. Complete. Paid $6 for that one. Got a copy here of Soldier of Fortune 2 Double Helix, and it's an only on Xbox title. Complete. Got that one for $6. Another Xbox-only title is Far Cry Instincts, which I love the Far Cry series. I haven't played this one in a long time. If you love the newer ones, definitely recommend go back and play some of these older ones. They were definitely really cool. Great condition. It's complete. And I paid $6 for that. Grabbed another Harry Potter title I needed, and that was Harry Potter Quidditch World Cup. My girlfriend's a big Harry Potter fan, so I know she's going to enjoy playing this. It's complete. I got that for $6. Grabbed a copy of Hitman Blood Money. I actually thought I had this one for the longest time, but I actually have it on PS2, not Xbox, so I had to pick up a copy for the Xbox. Definitely love the Hitman series. I'm looking forward to the new Hitman game that's going to be coming out later this year. It's complete. I got that one for $6. Next up, grabbed a copy of Hulk, which I love. Most of the Hulk games they've released, even since the Genesis days, are really awesome. And this one's just as fun. Very happy to have it. Haven't played it in a while, but when I did own it, I really liked it. So I'm glad to have another copy. It is complete. I got that for $6. Got a copy here of Freedom Fighters. It says it's from the makers of Hitman 2. I never played this when it first came out. I always wanted to, so I'm very happy that I own a copy because I can finally check it out and see how it is. If you guys ever played it, let me know how it is, but it looks really cool. That one's complete. I got that for $6. Finally found a copy of Full Spectrum Warrior 10 Hammers. I could always find Full Spectrum Warrior, but I could never find the 10 Hammers version, so very happy to finally get that one. It is complete, and I paid $6 for that. Grabbed a copy of The Incredibles, which is that was a pretty cool movie. I have this on the GameCube, and it's a pretty fun little game. So if you're looking for a nice little family game, I would recommend this one. Pretty cool. It is complete. And I got that for $6. Grabbed a copy here of Doom 3, Resurrection of Evil. It'll go along with my other Doom 3, so very happy with that. Complete. And I paid $7 for that. Next up, copy here of Starsky and Hutch. I had never played this one before. Definitely will have to check it out. Looks pretty cool. It is complete, and I paid $7 for that one. Grabbed a copy of Pac-Man World 2. I had the first Pac-Man World, and I needed to get Pac-Man World 2, so I picked that up. Great condition, and I paid $7 for that. Next two titles I picked up are pretty uncommon in my area. It's taken me a while to locate them, and that first one here is a copy of Psychonauts. It's a psychic adventure from the mind of Schaefer. This was a really awesome title. I remember playing this when it first came out. I rented it and loved it. Never did actually beat it. I always wanted to pick up a copy. I just kept putting it off, and I just never did pick up one. But I'm glad to have another copy now. In great condition. It is also complete. And I paid $25 for that, so very happy to add that to the collection. I would definitely recommend it. Very unique game, and it's really fun. You guys definitely need to pick it up. I know it's on PS2, but I'm not sure if it's on GameCube, but you know, pick up a copy if you can find one. Really cool. And the last Xbox title I picked up is one that I've been after for quite some time. It's one that I rarely see pop up in my area. Once in a while, I'll see a copy, but it's always been priced really high. This one was priced pretty reasonable about what it goes online, and that was Godzilla Save the Earth, which it just seems like recently, especially in my area, Godzilla games just keep going up and up in value and demand for them. Like, they rarely have them in stock. This one was only there for 2 hours before I picked it up, and I got that for $50, kind of pricey, but it's one I needed for the collection, and I love Godzilla games, and I'm very happy to finally mark that one off the collect list, so glad to have that. I definitely would recommend the newer Godzilla games, Godzilla, I think it's Melee. Definitely good games to get on the Xbox. You can also get some of them on the GameCube and PS2. Definitely worth picking up if you're a Godzilla fan. Very happy to have this. And now the last pickup to share with you guys. So happy to get this. It is a Nintendo 64 game that I need. I only had 5 left to complete the collection, and with this one it'll leave me with only 4. Was a pretty pricey title though. I had to resort to going to eBay. Just could not find it anywhere locally. It is a Blockbuster exclusive, which might give it away. And that was a copy of Clay Fighter Sculptor's Cut, which this cart is in amazing condition. Really good. Very happy to finally own this. I've been after this since I decided to go for the full collection, but I could just never find it locally. So I had to finally break down, pick it up on eBay. And it did cost me a little under $300 for it, which is crazy. I know, for a really terrible game, but it's one I needed for my collection, and it just keeps going up in value. And if I just kept waiting around, you know, I would end up having probably pay $500 or more for this if I wait another couple of years. So I just decided I'd go ahead and buy a copy. It actually really only cost me about $50 out of pocket, because I've been selling some extra games and consoles on Craigslist, so I use that money to help pay for this. Very glad to add this to the collection. I only need 4 more titles. And it was cool. The guy even tossed in a Universal game case with the printed out cover. So that's awesome. I don't have to go do print out that for it now. So very happy with that. I only need 4 more titles, and I can't wait to complete the 64 collection. Once I do complete the collection, I will do a collection video for you guys. And then I want to go through my carts and look for any that are kind of beat up. And I'm just going to start upgrading them. And then I'll just keep mainly focusing on completing my original Xbox collection. If you guys want other ways to connect with me, you know, be sure you guys check out my Facebook page. It's facebook.com/AsiansLeepy1. You guys can also check out my Weebly page. I'll have the links for both of those down below in the description. And on my Weebly page, I constantly update that with new games I find. I have a page on there for all the Xbox titles I'm looking for, so, you know, check out the list and see if there's any on there that you might have up for trade. I also have a page up there with games that I have for trade. So if you guys see anything that you want or are interested in, just let me know. You know, you can leave a message here. You can send me a private message. You can even send a message to me on Facebook. All right, I want to thank you guys for watching. Take care. Have a wonderful day. And Sleepy will see you guys next time.